What's up guys, welcome back to the channel. So what I'm doing now is showing you guys the difference between the Samsung KS8000 and the brand new Samsung Q7FN. Now what I'm going to be doing is just kind of walking you through verbally, because you're not going to see this through YouTube, but I know if I do not go through and actually show you guys the differences, quite a few people will probably be upset about it. So I'm gonna make sure to just kind of tell you guys the differences as I am seeing them. So the first difference that I noticed personally, the QLED obviously is brighter. That is one of the things that sticks out like pretty much a sore thumb. So aside from being brighter, it also maintains a lot better vibrancy overall. But as far as like shades of color, in terms of shades and color and things like that, it does not like outdo the KS8000 too much, to a point where it just can't compete. I mean, they look so similar, and in some cases the KS8000 is actually more vibrant because it has a better, you know, more accurate color space management system. So again, it's just all about, you know, what you need when you need it, I suppose. But what I can tell you guys from what I'm seeing here, both are very, very, very decent TVs for what they are. But for me, I mean, it's not an $1,800 picture on the Q7FN, and it is way too close to the Samsung KS8000. I mean, now obviously colors are more vibrant because it's a newer television and the newer technology is being leveraged, and it's a lot closer to, you know, the vibrancy that you would expect on something like the Sony X900E. But again, it's just not, I don't know, it's really hard to really put it in like everyday terms, because I mean, yeah, sure, you could do the technical talk, but that doesn't really help everyday people, you know what I mean? That just kind of, you know, helps the pretentious crowd out there kind of, you know, dick measure, I guess, which is not what I'm after. I'm really after just giving you guys honest information as honest buyers. And I mean, like, if you have a KS8000 right now, KS8500, KS9500, KS9000, and you're thinking about upgrading, maybe, you know, you saw the Q7FN, maybe you get a sale, maybe you see something, and you're wondering, is it really worth it? Should I make the step up for the 100% color volume? No, absolutely not. Don't do it. Because, I mean, coming from a Samsung KS8000, I'm telling you right now, you're missing out on that illumination LED at the bottom. I like that feature where Samsung's logo is lit up. That's another really nice high-end feature that this product just doesn't seem to have, like, at all. Like, I've looked for it, I've tried to find it in the menus, it's just nowhere. So for me, that's one of the big, like, aggravating factors for me with this particular product. Because again, you're talking about, you're paying a premium and you're getting into this flagship line of Samsung TVs. So you would think that they would give you guys a little bit something more than just the bare minimum, hey, here's your product. And I mean, it goes right down to the remote. It's such a trashy way to do business. I mean, you're getting the MU series remote on a QLED. It's just like a slap in the face every step of the way. So to be really frank and really honest, I'm not surprised that I'm seeing scale backs in terms of color. And really the only big benefit this year is the brightness, really. The brightness is very impressive, it is. But the contrast is lacking behind the brightness and things just kind of fall apart quickly. Now the sharpness is amazing, it looks really, really clean, really, really good. And motion is a lot better than on the KS series that I found anyway. But again, it's just, when you're talking about both displays, both being calibrated to D65 white, which they are, it's, the Samsung KS8000 was easier to get better results a lot quicker. So for me, I just kind of lean more that way anyway. So that's just kind of what I have to say on that particular note there. Now again, it's not to say that one is not capable of producing, you know, a wow effect. Because again, if this is your first time buying a 4K television, it's very easy to be wowed by the brightness, by the color. And if you see a lot of my reviews, you're going to be like, wow, Quantum, what are you even talking about? But here's the thing. We're talking about a high-end level. We're talking about a guy in Quantum Apotheosis that not only calibrates TVs on a regular basis, but I'm also used to seeing high-quality performance out of these televisions. And I'm telling you right now, if you're expecting that, you know, coming from like an OLED, coming from, you know, flagship, you know, SUHD TV, even from 2015, and you're wondering, should you upgrade? This is not going to be that upgrade that you were looking for it to be. Like, I personally saw the 100% color volume advertisements, and I was like, wow, this is mind-blowing. This is stuff I got to get my hands on. And then seeing it and a 2018 television is not impressive. I mean, yes, it's brighter. Yes, things are slightly more vibrant. But I'm telling you, as far as shades of color, looking at it right now, as I'm looking at the replay, I'm telling you right now, it looks better on the Samsung as far as like shades of color, both calibrated, and black levels are better managed on the Samsung KS8000 as well. So it's just kind of like pick your poison, I suppose. But for me, if you're looking for that definitive answer, there you go. Now, also in terms of gaming, I know that this is also a very subjective thing. Not everybody is a gamer. Not everybody is looking at video gaming content. And you probably want more varying comparisons, but it's important to know this. I can't give you guys everything. Like, I can't do like the copyrighted content and all this stuff because, again, that's just not what I'm able to do in such a limited amount of time. Because to be very honest with you, after what I saw, after what I know about this product, there's absolutely no way I could recommend this safely to anybody. This is just a product that is like, it's halfway there, but for the money, there are better things out there. Now, if this product was to be like maybe the price of, let's say, the TCL P607, I would recommend this like breakfast, lunch, and dinner. Like, yeah, you totally need this in your life. But for the money that they're asking for, I mean, you're talking about like, dude, like, shit. I mean, we're talking about $1,800 American dollars. $1,697 plus tax is going to be $1,800 no matter how you slice it in whatever state you're in. It's just, that's just what it is in America anyway. Now, for my European viewers and other international viewers, it might be different for you, but yeah, no, this is not like that end all to be all. I know I've said that like a million times in this video, and there's reason for that. I am seeing early on in the comment sections people really upset and really disgruntled. Not a lot of people, majority kind of understand where I'm going with this, but I'm seeing a few people that are saying like, oh, your settings are wrong, you haven't calibrated this correctly. You know, all I do is follow the freaking steps on the Kalman software. You know, you do your white balance adjustments, you do everything that the software basically tells you to do once you follow the target points on the graphs. I mean, you literally just follow the marker. It marks it and lays everything out for you. I mean, it's so easy a caveman can do it for people who know the, you know, those old Geico commercials. But, you know, that's how I feel right now. I mean, it's not hard to calibrate your television. I mean, buy the Kalman software, I guarantee you, you'll pick it up in a day. It's not hard. So to say that I didn't calibrate this correctly, I mean, how stupid do I have to be not to do that? I mean, it's easy stuff. The problem is, people don't want to accept that there is something wrong with the product. And again, this television has visible ABL. You just saw it right there. Right there. You just saw it. Right as I was thinking in my brain to say it, it's on camera. So, you know, when this has ABL and my 2016 Samsung doesn't, it's continual brightness across the board, I'm of course going to recommend a product that you already own that you don't need to step up into. And, you know, quite frankly, shades of color are easier managed, you know, because Samsung really gave it their all in 2016 launching their SUHD line, and where now they're just kind of like, screw you, you get the crap into the stick. So, long-winded, don't buy this television kind of review, if you will. Side-by-side comparison KS8000 versus this, but I really need you guys to understand, if you have a 2016, 2015 Samsung and you are, you know, you have the hots, should you get this television, it seems like that deal, don't do it. All right, I've warned you a million and one times, I did my part. That being said, I really hope you guys enjoyed this video. You guys can see what I'm talking about. My name is Quantum Apotheosis, bringing you guys the apotheosis of information. Thank you guys so much, ABL again, by the way, for stopping by, being a part of the channel. And until next time, I'll see you guys later.